Hi friends. All life comes from the life of its own kind. If we see here the life of a plant, the life of a man, the life of a chimpanzee, and the life of a panda comes from its own kind, which are also a plant, a man, a chimpanzee, and panda. And they inherit its characteristic in unbroken linkage from their ancestors. The book of Genesis states that each creature brought forth according to its own kind. In general, the plants are generated from the seed of the plant, while some of the plants are self-generated from the similar components of the seed. Life had a beginning. What is the mechanism involved in the origin of life? Since the origin of living organisms, did they change through time? And obviously, yes, they change. The evolution of a man is the perfect example for these changes through time. Human body is a miracle. Its interconnected system is the most advanced structure in the known universe. It is a marvel of biochemical and biomechanical engineering. And all these complex systems are continuing through generations. And how is it possible? And what is the mechanism involved here? And we normally hear that you are looking like your papa, your eyes are looking like your grandma. Actually, it is maintained by the continuity of genetic material. What is genetic continuity? The passing of genetic material from generations to the generations. And these are determined by the genes. Genes. These are the sequences of DNA which are found on chromosomes in cell. Next, what maintains genetic continuity? It is maintained by the DNA replication which occurs during the cell cycle through the process called reproduction. Reproduction, it is a complex phenomenon of nature which is found in every living organism. It may be asexual reproduction or sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, only single parent take involvement here, and here the offsprings are similar to their parents. Sexual reproduction, here the involvement of two parents takes place and the formation of gamete takes place here, and here the fusion of gametes, it gives the new generation maintaining the same number of chromosomes. Here are the examples. If you see, human beings possess the 46 chromosomes, and rat possess the 42 chromosomes, and watermelon possesses the 22 chromosomes, which are present in the cell. Cell, it is the basic unit of life. Each cell consists of nucleus and genetic material. In general, this cell remains in the resting phase. If it starts division, then the chromatin material is condensed to the chromosomes. And here the cell cycle. It contains the phases like G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase, and M phases. And here the genetic continuity, it is done by the DNA replication which occurs in this S phase. And in this S phase, the single chromatid is converted into the sister chromatids. In somatic cell, the division takes place by the process called mitosis. In mitosis, the same number of chromosomes are passed from the parent cell to the daughter cell. As this mitosis is an asexual reproduction, the involvement of single parent takes place here, and here the daughters are exact copies of their parents. Why? Because here there is no variation takes place. In reproductive cell, the division takes place by the process called meiosis. As this meiosis occurs in the sexual reproduction, here the involvement of two parents takes place. For example, if we consider the human beings, the sperm of the male contains 46 chromosomes, and the ova of the female contains 46 chromosomes. When they get fertilized, then it results in the 92 chromosomes. And again, for 92 plus 92 chromosomes, it gives 184 chromosomes. And it continues further through generations, and its number increases. But this is not happening here. Why? This is the secret hidden in this meiosis, which the process called reduction division. For example, if we take the human beings, again the male of the sperms of the male contains the 23 chromosomes and the ova of the female contains the 23 chromosomes. When they fertilize, they give the 46 chromosomes for every generation. That is the maintaining of genetic continuity through millions of years. Cell. This cell contains the chromosomes, and chromosomes consists of number of genes. Gene, it is the basic unit of heredity. And this gene contains the genetic material, which is called as the DNA. DNA, it is the basic unit and it is the genetic material. This DNA is discovered by the scientist known as Friedrich Miescher, and its double helical structure was explained by the scientist Watson and Crick. And this DNA, it is a double helical structure and it will be seen in the every living organisms. And here, it in each strand of the DNA, it is consists of the four types of the nucleotides. And the nucleotide consists of the phosphate and the sugar as well as the nitrogen bases. As I had said in the earlier, this DNA replication takes place in the S phase. Okay, and here are some of the major forms of the DNA. They are A form DNA, B form DNA and Z form DNA. In this, the B form DNA is the most common. As I said, in the cell cycle, in the S phase, the DNA replication takes place. And here, DNA replication, it is a semi-conservative process and it occurs in every living organism, acting as the basis for the biological inheritance. And this DNA replication, it occurs in the three steps: initiation, elongation and termination. Here, initiation. In this initiation, before this DNA can be replicated, it must be unzipped into the two single strands. Here, adenine pairs up only with the thymine and guanine only pairs up with the cytosine. In order to unwind this nitrogen, the bonds between these, they should be broken. And here the enzyme DNA helicase will be useful for that. So this DNA helicase, it will interrupt the bond between these two base pairs and it forms the Y shape, which is called as the replication fork. And this replication fork acts as the template for the replication to begin. And here, this DNA is directional in both strands, which are assigned by the 5-N and 3-N. This 5-N, it is attached to the phosphate group, and 3-N, it is attached to the hydroxyl group. If we take the replication fork, it is bidirectional, in which one strand is oriented in the 3-to-5- direction and another strand is oriented in the 5-to-3- direction. And in this replication, this directionality is very important. Why? Because it possesses only in the 5-to-3- direction. And next, this leading strand is the simplest to replicate. Once this DNA strand is broken, so here the RNA primase, a piece of the RNA called the primer, it will start or it will initiate the replication here. And it is generated by the enzyme called as a primase. And next process is the elongation process. In this elongation process, the enzyme called as the DNA polymerase, it binds with this primer and starts the formation of new strand. And this DNA polymerases is different kinds in the human cells, like DNA polymerases alpha, beta and epsilon, which are the primary polymerases which are involved in this DNA replication. If we consider the leading strand, in this leading strand, this replication process is continuous. Why? Because the newly formed strand is continuous here. And if we take the lagging strand. In this lagging strand, these primers bind at the several positions. Here, the DNA polymerase adds some of the fragments, DNA fragments called Okazaki fragments, in between these primers. So, by that, this lagging strand is a discontinuous. Why? Because these Okazaki fragments are disjointed here. And the last process is the termination. Here, the enzyme known as the exonuclease, it will remove all these primers and will attaches or replaces the base pairs. And another enzyme called as the ligase, it will join all these fragments and forms the new strand. So, once this replication is finished, the parent strand and its complementary strand, they both will coil together and form the double helical structure. So, at last in the DNA replication, from a single DNA, we are getting the two DNA strands. And here, the single chromatid is converted into the sister chromatids. As these sister chromatids, will cross over and forms the chiasmata in the prophase 1 of the meiosis, which is occurs in the sexual reproduction. As I said that in sexual reproduction, two parents are involved. So, the one chromatid from the mother and one chromatid from the father, these will undergo the crossover and forms the chiasmata. And this leads to the exchange of the genetic material. And because of this exchange of genetic material, the variations takes place. And we can see these variations in every living organisms in this universe. And if we go to the daily life applications, there are many factors which can affect the genetic material. So here the external factors like availability of raw material, radiations, toxins, viruses, and the environment. And internal factors like nutrients, genetic code, mutations, chemicals, and addition and the deletion of the chromosomes. And not only these factors, we are also having some of the factors like the smoking, which is a bad habit. And next is the pollution, which is the critical case which is going in our society now. And the inflammation and ionization radiations, which are occurring from the industrialization. And because of all these factors, the chemical matter inside the cell is being disturbing. And it forming the free radicals. And because of this, the DNA damage takes place. Means here, the DNA damage means nothing but the breakage of single strand or the breakage of a double strand. So because of this DNA damage, we are getting some of the mutations. And these mutations are leading to the genetic disorders. So by all these factors, whatever internal factors and the external factors, and because of this formation of free radicals, because of smoking, pollution, and ionization radiation, so the DNA is getting damaged, and because of that, mutations are taking place, and it leads to the genetic disorders. And here are the common genetic disorders like cystic fibrosis, alpha beta thalassemia, hemophilia, sickle cell anemia, Down syndrome, and the color blindness. So these are some of the common genetic disorders. So interesting thing is that the hemophilia, it is first found in the Queen Victoria family. So it is called as a royal disorder. So from the Queen Victoria to the present generation, this disease was maintained continuously. And maybe it will continue to the further generations also. And the next common disease is the sickle cell anemia. This sickle cell anemia is caused due to the point mutation of the DNA, which codes for the beta globulin polypeptide chain of the hemoglobin molecule, which is caused by the replacement of the glutamic acid in the sixth position by valine. So, in order to get rid over this disorder, in this scientific and technological life, we had the therapies to some extent, like gene therapy, stem cell transfusion, and the blood transfusion. So by these treatments, we can get rid of this disorder to some extent. And for all genetic disorders, we had the treatment here, like the gene therapy, gene transplants, gene recombination, and the DNA recombination, bone marrow transplants. So by these treatments, we can get rid of these genetic disorders. So instead of this, to maintain the healthy genetic material for our future generations, we should have to adapt some of the good habits. So that good habits are, we should have to do the exercise daily, and we should have to take the plenty of water, and we should have to maintain the good balanced diet, and we should have to feel happy for every moment. By adapting these good habits, we can maintain the healthy genetic material for our future generations also. So by that, our future generations will be in the good position, and they can be rid of these genetic disorders. So here we got the final answer, that this genetic continuity, it is maintained by the DNA replication. This DNA replication will occur in the cell cycle, which is carried by the reproduction. And I said this reproduction is asexual and the sexual. So while in this process, in this genetic continuity process, we had some variations, and we had some of the point mutations, and we had some of the genetic disorders. So in order to get rid of this, we had also the treatments in this present generation, and we had also some of the therapies, and we had also some of the medications. And not only that, so the factors which are around in our environment, these all are affecting our genetic material. So by this effect of the genetic material, we are posing to the genetic disorders. So in order to get rid of this, we had the good habits here, like maintaining these exercises and everything. This genetic continuity, it is a very good process. So if we see here, from our ancestors, we are continued to till now here. And it was also continuous for the future generations also. In this continuity, if we take the sexual reproduction, in this the variations are occurring. That I said, in the meiosis, the crossing over takes place and the chiasmata will form. So because of this, variations occurs. So that's why these organisms which were undergo the sexual reproduction, they won't look exact copy of their parents. But if we take the asexual reproduction, in this asexual reproduction, as mitosis takes place here, there is no variation occurs. So here the daughters are exact copies of their parents. So by this mitosis process and by this meiosis process, in this asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction, in every living organisms, this genetic continuity is maintaining. And the main factor is that in this reproduction, as we see here, the parent contains the 46 chromosomes. If you take the human beings, the exact number of 46 chromosomes are passing to the daughter. And from this daughter to the next future generations. And it continues for the generations to the generations. Here the main point is that the constant number of chromosomes are continuing from generations to the generations. And this was done by the DNA replication in the nucleus of the cell. And this DNA replication, this was maintaining the genetic continuity for our future generations. And at last, we all life forms comes from the life of its own kind. And we have known about the genetic continuity. And it is maintained by the DNA replication by the process called reproduction. And here by this reproduction process, the same number of chromosomes are passing from the generations to the generations. And it is done by the cell cycle. So in this cell cycle, we contains the S phase where the DNA replication takes place here. And here this DNA replication, here the DNA, which is the basic unit of the life and which is the basic unit of the heredity. And because of these DNA replications, the genetic continuity is maintained. And in this process, whatever the take place in the prophase, that the crossing over and the chiasmata, the variations are occurring in every living organisms. That's why we are with different colors. If we take the giraffe, they are with the different patches. And not only the variations, some of the mutations were taking place here, which are leading to the genetic disorders. And these mutations are taking place because of the external and the internal factors, and because of the factors which are around our environment. So here, one of the measure we should have to take that. So we should have to keep the concentration on our environment. We should have to adopt some new policies to maintain the good environment. So then our genetic continuity will be also healthy. So because of that, we are getting the genetic disorders. And for these genetic disorders in the scientific and the daily life, we had the some of the treatments like gene therapy, DNA recombination and gene recombination. And these recombinations were also being discarded by the scientists which are present in this future, in these generations. And because of these disorders, the genetic continuity is not genetic continuity, the genetic material is being affected. So for that, we can adapt the good habits like feeling good always and doing the exercises and taking the good food, means nothing but the good balanced diet, and taking the plenty of water. So by this, we can maintain the good genetic continuity, means nothing but the healthy genetic continuity for our future generations also. And here, finally, I want to say that there is no end for this genetic continuity. It continues until the life exists on the earth. Up to the life exists on this earth, this genetic continuity will be proceeded. It doesn't have end for any generation. From starting to the evolution, from starting to the ancestors, and to the future generations, because of DNA replication, this genetic continuity is maintained. And it will also maintain to our future generations also. Means, this future generations means nothing but until the life exists on this earth. So there is no end for this genetic continuity, and we don't know until to which this genetic continuity will be proceeded. But until the life exists on this earth, this genetic continuity will be maintained. So at last, it doesn't has the end. It is a continuous process until the life exists on this earth, which is maintained by the DNA replication. And this DNA is the genetic material, which is present in every living organism. In the process of reproduction, this DNA will be get replicated. And in this replication, the constant number of chromosomes will be maintained from the generation to the generation. So in this process, the genetic material is passing from the parent to the daughter, and it was continuing to the generations. So this is about the genetic continuity. So my topic is here, the what maintains genetic continuity. It is done by the DNA replication. And finally, there is no end for this DNA replication. There is no end for this DNA replication process. Means nothing but there is no end for this genetic continuity. So it will be continuous until the life exists on this earth. And thank you for giving me this opportunity. And I thank to the government of Telangana and the TSAT network, and our beloved secretary, sir, Praveen Kumar, sir, and my principal, ma'am, and my mentor, ma'am. Thank you for giving me this opportunity at this young age. Thank you.